Hi guys, now we are running with the chapter which is non-alcoholic beverages. We have already discussed what is non-alcoholic beverages and the classification of non-alcoholic beverages. Okay. Basically, the classifications are the non-alcoholic beverages are classified into three: stimulating beverages, nourishing beverages, and refreshing beverages. Okay. So we have already started with stimulating beverages, which is tea, coffee, and cocoa. Okay. So all of you know what is stimulating beverage, isn't it? The stimulating beverage means a beverage which stimulate your nerve system, which stimulate your blood pressure. Okay. So tea, coffee, and cocoa, which has the alkaloids. Example: caffeine, theine. These are the alkaloids which are present in the stimulating beverages, which increase your blood pressure, which increase your blood pressure, and which stimulate your nerve system. That is why you feel stimulated when you take these beverages. Example: tea, coffee, and cocoa. So usually, when you wake up, you used to have tea. You used to have coffee. Why? Because it stimulates your body. It will give an energy to your daily life. Okay, that is why we are taking tea and coffee in the morning. Okay, so we have already discussed tea. We have already discussed cocoa. How it is produced? How tea and cocoa is produced? What are the different brands and their service and uses? So now today we are going to discuss about coffee. What is coffee? How it is manufactured? Different types of coffee and the brand names. Okay. So I hope all of you knows what is coffee. Coffee. Every one of you used to take coffee in the morning, isn't it? Or at least once you have tried what is coffee. Okay. So coffee. It's the popular drink in the world. Let's see how the history says coffee has cultivated 1000 years ago in Yemen, in Arabian country. And there are two species which is known as Cafe Arabica and Cafe Robusta, which are the two species which is commonly used for making coffee beans, okay, or cultivating coffee or making coffees. So these are the two the species which is used. One is Cafe Arabica and Cafe Robusta. Cafe Arabica, which is the most delicate coffee, which is having good aroma and flavor, and which is used widely in and around the world. And the other one is Cafe Robusta, which is having less quality compared to Cafe Arabica. These are the two common species of coffee which is grown in around the world for making coffee. Okay, so this is about the history of coffee. Now let's see how the coffee is processed. What is the manufacturing method of coffee? Okay, so when we talk about the processing, coffee processing, the first step is harvesting. So the harvesting, what happens is the coffee fruit, okay, the coffee fruits, when it is ripened or when it is ready for the manufacturing process, the coffee beans, the coffee berries are plucked or harvested from the tree, and it is sent for fermentation. Fermentation is nothing but it is an oxidation method, oxidation process, where the coffee beans are, the coffee beans are contact with air, and it will create some chemical changes. So fermentation process where the fruits, the fruit part is removed. We will take off the seeds inside. The coffee beans, inside the coffee fruit, which will be taken out. And the next process is drying. The water content of the coffee beans has to be removed. So what we do is, after the fermentation, after removing the pulp or the fruit from the seeds, we send the coffee beans to a drying process where the coffee beans are spread on the floor in front of the sun. Under the sunlight, we do the drying process. Okay. So after drying, the coffee beans will be sent for roasting. Again, there are three types of roasting: light roasting, medium roasting, and full roasting. Okay, there are different. This is depends on the different temperature. Okay, the light roasting gives the light coffees. Medium roasting, which gives a medium coffee, medium flavored coffee, and full roasting, which gives a full dark coffee, which is high in flavor, sometimes bitter in taste. Okay, then after the roasting, it is sent for grinding. Usually, we don't do grinding immediately after roasting. Grinding is usually done when sometimes just before making coffee. Okay, so grinding is not involved in the processing of making coffee. Usually, the coffee beans after roasting, the coffee beans will be packed, okay, or compact. Then once we are making coffee, or when we make coffee, that is the time only we do grind the coffee beans. Okay, so let's see different types of coffee which is available in the market. Okay, so different types of coffee: espresso. Espresso is a coffee which is Italian origin. Espresso is a small amount of coffee which is the ground coffee powder. The water, the boiling water, will be forced through coffee grounded coffee, and which gives a dark small quantity of bitter coffee, which is known as espresso, which is served in. The next coffee is Americano. It's again Italian origin. It is espresso based coffee. Espresso, one shot of espresso with hot boiling water, that is known as Americano. This is our normal black coffee. We can say it is a black coffee. Then we have cappuccino. It is again Italian origin. Cappuccino, it's a coffee, espresso based coffee, espresso with milk foam, more milk foam is used in making cappuccino. The next is caffè latte. Again, it is an Italian origin coffee, originated in Italy. Caffè latte is a espresso based coffee, which is the word itself, caffè latte, which means coffee with milk. That is the meaning of caffè latte. And here the difference is cappuccino, where we use more milk form, but here in latte we use coffee and milk, and which is flavored with chocolate powder and sometimes cinnamon powders. So next is caffè mocha. Caffè mocha, it's again coffee, a different type of coffee, a coffee which is flavored with chocolate. Okay, so these are some different types of coffee. And when we discuss about methods of coffee, how the different methods, how we produce coffee or how we make coffees. Espresso coffee, we already discussed what is espresso coffee. We are using an espresso coffee making machine. With the help of that, we are making espresso coffee. Then there is Kona coffee. There is a Kona coffee machine which is available in the market. Percolator method, French press, filter coffee. Turkish coffee, again it's a Turkish method. There is a small kind of vessel is used for making this type of coffee. Coffee powder is put into this small vessel with hot water and we boil it. Okay, it's a Turkish style coffee. Then the last one is instant coffee method. This is what we are using, basically do it in our house, home. Instant coffee method, nothing but we boil water. We have the instant coffee powders. So what we does is, in a cup we put instant coffee, then we add boiling water. Okay, so these are some methods of making coffee. The videos of these methods of coffee are to be uploaded in my site. All of you can look into it, so you will understand more about these different types of these different methods of coffee making methods. Okay, so let's talk about some brand names of coffee which is available in the market. Koor, Nescafe, Green Label, Illy, which is from Italy, Java. These are the common brands which is international brands which is available in the market, and also Starbucks, they are also have coffee, so also an international coffee brand which is available in the market. Okay, this is all about the coffee. And when we talk about the storage of coffee, with after making after processing, the coffee beans or coffee powders are stored in an airtight container. Okay, if it is not airtight containers, what happens is every day the 20% of the quality, the aroma, the flavor will be lost. Okay, so when we talk about the storage, the coffee powders has to be stored in an airtight container. Okay, and it should not be exposed with any food items, or it should not be stored in a beside any highly near to any food item, because the coffee will attract the smell of the food and it will get spoiled. Okay, then also in an airtight container, well ventilated room, not exposed with sunlight. Okay, this is, these are some guidelines about the storage of coffee. So I hope all of you understand the brief idea about coffee, how it is manufactured, the history of the coffee, the different types of coffee, the manufacturing methods of coffee. In the manufacturing methods of coffee, I have already uploaded some videos which shows you or which explain you more about the different methods of making coffee, the equipments, the Kona coffee, the Kona coffee making machines. That all you can see in the video, and you will learn more about it. And also the printed notes, the notes will be uploaded to your in your site, so that you can download it. If you have any further clarification, you can contact me. Thank you guys.